It's the most widely accepted explanation for this global health emergency, that COVID-19 first infected humans in a Wuhan wet market.
It's unbelievable. It's extraordinary that the World Health Organization sees it fit for these wet markets to continue in China. They shouldn't.
And if Australia has its way, it won't. Our government calling for a more proactive approach.
Be able to go into areas where a virus of potential pandemic implications can be understood quickly.
The proposal would see the WHO given similar powers to UN weapons inspectors, the ability to enter countries without seeking permission to stop dangerous practices early on.
So since 1980, there's been six pandemics that have been of animal origin, and two, that is SARS and this COVID-19 outbreak, associated with wildlife wet markets.
But not everyone wants to demonise these markets. The WHO says they're a vital source of food for millions, and experts claim they're misunderstood.
Wet markets was translated wrongly in the West. In Chinese, those markets are called produce markets. Those average wet market in China doesn't look very differently from a farmer's market here in Australia.
The main difference is a wide variety of live animals is sold alongside processed and prepared products.
The issue is that if we close these markets down, that in some countries, in some circumstances, that'll mean that some people will go without protein.
China's not happy with Australia's rhetoric and is unlikely to welcome WHO inspectors.
By 2017, the only live animal that can be sold in this wet market has been just fish. This particular wet market in Wuhan, where allegedly COVID-19 originated in, that market has about 600 stores under it, and 8 of them have got license for wildlife trade. Questions need to be asked about that particular market, and also asked about general wildlife trade in China.
Federal Agriculture Minister David Littleproud joins us now. Minister, is it the Australian government's position that these markets be shut down?
Well, what we're saying is that these wildlife wet markets that differentiate themselves from a normal wet market, and that's an important distinction that everyone should understand. A wet market is like the Sydney fish markets, perfectly safe. But what the wildlife markets are is that they bring together wildlife along with domestic animals and humans all in one place. And that can create a cocktail that we are seeing through COVID-19. And what we want to do is get the science in a calm, methodical way with the best experts in the world to understand whether those risks can be mitigated. And if they can't, well, how do we have those conversations with these developing nations that have these types of markets in a calm way that allows them to transition, because this underpins a lot of their food security and food supply. We're part of a global community and we've got to act as a global community, and that's what I'm asking for us to come together and to get this right to protect human lives and to protect agricultural production systems around the world.
Hence the idea of effectively UN inspectors, kind of like we have for weapons. You may have noticed that the weapons inspection stuff doesn't always go very smoothly, doesn't always go well. Wars don't always get prevented just because they're in place. You'd ultimately be relying on the cooperation of China, wouldn't you? Are you confident that you would get that?
Well, let me say, this is differential to what the Prime Minister's been asking around the World Health Organization. This would be calling on the World Organization for Animal Health, an organization that China has actively participated in for 10 years. And if these aren't just isolated in China, they're in other developed nations in Africa and throughout Asia and even in South America. So let's look at each one of those. We've got to understand they each have their own idiosyncrasies and their own science. But we should have that conversation, undertake that science, because it's just as important to them as it is to us. It underpins their food security, it underpins our safety as human beings.
Minister, China's already shut down nearly 20,000 wildlife farms. They appear to be taking action. Doesn't that indicate they're serious about the problem?
They have, and in fact, during the SARS crisis, they temporarily shut these markets, these wildlife wet markets down, and that's a great step, and that's a great basis to work from. But not just China isn't the only nation that has these. And as I said, the globe's got a lot smaller, and we've become a global community where we have to act together.
David, the government is saying that the World Health Organization should be regulating this. Do you have confidence that they can actually do the job?
Well, obviously, we're a contributor to the World Health Organization, and we want to see that the best outcomes are portrayed globally, and that's important while we contribute to that. And when we hit these types of events, it's important, and the most important part of that is communication. And I think what we're saying as a government, any organisation that's in one of these crises always needs to learn from those things that they believe they could do better, and those that are tied into this believe they can do better. That's having open and transparent conversation in a mature way, and we shouldn't apologise for the fact that Australia's leading this conversation. Someone has to initiate it. We want to keep a level of maturity to it so that it benefits all of the global community, not just Australia. We're part of the global community. We want to be a good citizen, and that's what Australia is trying to do.
Well, we do appreciate your time tonight. Thanks for joining us, Minister.
Thanks for having me.
I thought the Minister spoke really calmly and really sensibly then, maybe a little bit calmer than Josh Frydenberg was.
Well, yeah.
You can understand the Treasurer's frustrations at the moment, but the important distinction between regular wet markets and the wet markets that then sell dealing wildlife as well is an important distinction.
Yeah. And I think we're quick to sort of demonise them, and we're quick to sort of be blaming, obviously, because we want to get to the point of fixing this so we don't happen again. But there's a great point here from Pete on Facebook that says, Chinese markets in these areas are like our Coles or Woolies, so closing them will get strong resistance. Maybe we should focus on what is sold there, not closing the markets themselves, because culturally these are very important to Chinese
people.
But
the thing that gets me is when the World Health Organization said exactly this and said this is really important for people's wellbeing and for people's health, they got absolutely smashed for it.
Yeah.
And our government was part of that, saying this is an outrageous decision.
We often don't ask the next question, do we? We just hear wet markets and they're demonised and we're outraged. But I'm glad you read out my comment from Facebook.
Yeah.
Thanks for that.